The work of Robert Townsend has helped us better understand how it is that poorer people in developing economies insure themselves and each other. Townsend has spent a lot of his career at University of Chicago and MIT. Townsend's early work was in very mathematical branches of economic theory, such as principal agent theory and monetary theory, but over time he's actually become much more of what you might call a quantitative economic anthropologist. Starting in 1998, he went to Thailand and, choosing 16 villages, began to collect systematic data on the incomes and consumption patterns of individual families in those villages. This became a data set of unprecedented quality. When you think of the recent trend in development economics toward developing one's own data set and going out in the field and getting very specific information about individuals, Townsend on this was really a methodological pioneer. The work of Townsend is important not only for its method, but what we learn from that method. So Townsend and his co-authors have taken these many years of data from Thailand and to some extent India and asked questions about risk. How do individuals respond to risk? What if there's a bad crop one year, perhaps because of bad weather? What happens if some other catastrophe or misfortune befalls a family? How do incomes respond? How do consumption patterns respond? These were the questions which motivated his data-gathering efforts. Townsend's work shows that even when explicit insurance markets are absent, in the sense of you can't go out and buy a policy from an insurance company, there are nonetheless many forms of implicit insurance, which can involve gifts or favor trading or loans or sharing of income or other kinds of mutual aid. In one of his papers, he found that gifts from other households in the same village equal about 9% of average expenditure. That's quite a bit. If a negative shock hits an individual household in a village, that household tends to receive aid and loans from other households in the same village. If a negative shock hits an entire village, well, that village as a whole tends to receive aid and loans and other forms of indirect assistance from the surrounding region. These are, again, both forms of risk sharing. Townsend came up with some very clever empirical tests. For instance, imagine a world where there is no implicit insurance, and then there is a common negative shock hitting a village. What we would expect is that the decline of income for that village will predict a decline in consumption quite well, because the people in that village can't draw upon resources from anywhere else. But what Townsend finds is that in a lot of instances, what predicts consumption in the individual village is not shocks to the income of the village, but rather shocks to the income of the immediate surrounding region. So for instance, if the one village is doing poorly, but the region is doing better, there will be an inflow of resources, loans, aid, favor, trading, whatever. And if you find that it's the income of the surrounding region which is predicting village consumption, that means the broader region in some way is helping out the individual village through implicit insurance when the village needs that aid. Townsend's work shows some other very interesting results. For instance, individuals tend to be more insured if they have kin living in the same village. That is, there are more people who are willing and able to help them out. He finds also that entrepreneurs, on average, are the individuals who bear the most risk and who are least likely to receive insurance. Perhaps they simply have a taste for greater risk, or they have more resources. And Townsend finds that although implicit insurance is very important in these poorer villages, that in general there is not full insurance in these cases, so that when bad things happen at the level of an individual family or individual village, there is real suffering. There's an inflow of aid or loans, but that inflow doesn't make up completely for the bad event by any means. So exposure to risk is mitigated, but at the same time, exposure to risk really does matter. It's a striking result to find that individuals in relatively poor villages actually might be safer than you think. But this isn't just a general proclamation. Because of his data gathering and his extremely careful methods, Townsend has given us a pretty careful glimpse into exactly how risk sharing works in some poorer parts of the world. To learn more about Townsend, it's pretty simple and direct. Go to scholar.google.com, type in his name. Also, you can Google Robert Townsend Economist. He's not the only famous Robert Townsend, so put in that word economist. And also for his work on Thailand, just Google the Townsend Thai Project.